I'm in him, and Jesus, he's in me. Lord, we're in you. Lord Jesus, you're in us. And we praise you, Lord. We worship you. Hallelujah. Oh, 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 praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Ha 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 hallelujah. Oh hallelujah. Ha 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 hallelujah. Oh praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Oh praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Oh praise the Lord. Oh praise ye the Lord. Ha 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 ha. Shout to the Lord, and the rivers will flow. That has breath, we praise you, Lord. We have this breath that you gave, we praise you, Lord. Oh, praise ye the Lord. Oh, praise ye the Lord. And I will praise you. Oh God, I will praise you, my God. Oh, shout to the Lord, your Lord. Shout to the Lord, your Lord. Shout to the Lord, your Lord. We'll be right back.
satanako. Sikara satayana bahaya. Musu tarapapasu. Misatarabasito ropona maneo maneo. I will praise you, my Rabboni, my master. I will praise you, my Savior and my God. I will praise you, Lord Jesus. Oh, I will praise with all of my being. Shout to Lord with your voice. I will praise you, my God and my King. I will praise you, my Redeemer, my Jesus Christ the Lord. Shout to the Lord. Oh, shout to the Lord, and the rivers will flow. Supradeha. Shout to the Lord with your voice. Oh, shout to the Lord, and the rivers will flow. Shout to the Lord with your voice. I praise you, Rabboni, my master. I praise you, my Savior, my Savior. I praise you, my God. I praise you, my God and my King. I'll shout to the Lord with my voice. I praise you, oh Rabboni, my master. I praise you, my Savior, my Yeshua. I praise you, my God and my King, my Elohim HaMelech. Oh, I praise you, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Redeemer, Almighty God, Master of everything, Captain of our salvation, the Lord Most High. Deliverer, Savior. Shaddai, the Almighty, Sovereign God, Most High. Oh, crucified, buried, raised, ascended upon high, living ruler, Almighty God. Shout to the Lord with your voice. Shout. voice. Shout to the Lord with your voice, and the rivers will flow. Oh, of our God in His Christ, I praise you, Lord Jesus. I praise you, Rabboni. I praise you, Rabboni. I praise you, Hamelech. I praise you, Hamelech, the King. I praise you, El Shaddai. I praise you, El Shaddai. Shout to the Lord with your voice. Shout, 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 shout to the Lord with your voice. Shout to the Lord, and His rivers will flow. Shout. I praise you, Lord Jesus. Rabboni, I praise you, Rabboni. Hamelech, I praise you, Hamelech. I praise you, El Shaddai, El Shaddai, my Redeemer, my Savior, my Redeemer, my Deliverer, my Deliverer, my Redeemer, my light, oh, and my life, Jesus Christ, name above every name, the most powerful name of all. My Lord, my Christ, my Savior, Jesus, Rabboni, Hamelech, El Shaddai, in me, I'm in Him, family, Jesus. Crucified and buried and risen, ascended upon high, and sovereign rule, decider, the one who proclaims and defines and reveals everything that the Father's ever willed. Jesus, Savior, Jesus, Jesus, Rabboni, Rabboni, Jesus, Hamelech, Hamelech, Jesus, my King, my King. And forever I will shout the praises. Forever I will dance the dance. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Name above every name, every name, every name that is named. In this world, in the world to come, and everything must listen to His voice. Jesus Christ, He's the risen Lord in me. I'm here to testify that He's most high. Rabboni, the King. The risen Lord is risen in me, and I'm here to testify, to proclaim, relentlessly proclaim, Jesus is the Lord, sovereign Lord, who ruler of the world, Lord, sovereign Lord, Jesus is the Lord. Jesus, I praise you, Lord Jesus, I worship you. I worship you, oh Jesus, I praise you. I praise you, Rabboni, my master, my king. Rabboni, my master, my king. Ruling over everything of my life, my spirit, soul, and body. My mind is where you've written out your laws. My heart is where you inscribed all your ways. And my spirit you made one with your own. And my body you made your home. Jesus, I worship you. Amazing. Jesus, we praise your holy name. Rabboni, I bow my knees. Rabboni, I worship extravagantly. Rabboni, I bow my knees. Rabboni, I worship extravagantly. Jesus, we worship you. Lord Jesus, we praise your holy name. Rabboni, El Shaddai, Most High, El Elyon. Rabboni, El Shaddai, Elyon, Most High. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm gonna say to Manakea, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Mandela la voshipona mani. Just begin to shout to the Lord wherever you're at, wherever you find yourself. And the rivers of God will flow out of you. When you see something that would try to depress you or captivate you, begin to dance and praise Him. When something looks wrong, call it right in Jesus' name. Oh, start living by the Spirit and walking in the Word. And the heavenly life is yours. I praise you, Jesus, my Redeemer. Anybody in here tonight, you're not redeemed? I want you to know it's so easy. To be redeemed by the blood of the Lamb is to call upon the one who loves you so much, Christ Jesus, and He'll immediately come and rescue you and deliver you. He'll do a better job than Abraham did for Lot. He'll do a better job than Moses did for Israel. He'll do a better job than Elijah did for the prophets. He'll do a better job than anybody has ever been described, than Cyrus could do for Israel, than Nehemiah or Ezra could ever prop them up. Jesus Christ, who call upon His name, redemption comes. Redeemed, to be redeemed, to be brought back to oneness with God, to be in Him, Him in you, with the light of His love and glory shining bright like a noonday sun. The glory of the one, the only begotten Jesus, my Lord. Say Rabboni, Rabboni, I bow my knee. Rabboni, I worship extravagantly. Jesus. Chitara bombina hasta. Pitara nereki. Sistara mambre sistara nereki sahala. Every mama mana name mana mama mana say my Lord. My Lord. My cries. My Lord. My Lord. My Savior. My Lord. My Lord, the Redeemer of all mankind, Jesus, Jesus, my Master, my Ruler, Jesus, Prince of Peace, Jesus, King of Kings. King of Kings, Jesus, Lord, Lord of, I bow my knee, I worship you, Rabboni, Jesus. I don't care what you're up against, just do this. And I promise you it will not exist anymore. As a young child, my mother said, and she taught me something. She said, listen, we see everything in the framework of the eternal purposes of God. We see it as it exists in Him. We see it the way He sees it. We perceive it the way He perceives it. We think it the way He thinks it. And the Holy Ghost has come to teach us that. It's a new way of thinking. You must unlearn everything that you've learned to be taught a whole new way of thinking. And God in His grace and His mercy has come. And this is the new covenant. And this is what the Haredi, the Orthodox Jews, and anyone else who knows is looking for. And they need to see it in you, because God's going to use you to provoke them to jealousy. They're waiting to see a people who Jeremiah prophesied and Ezekiel prophesied that the ways of God would be written in their hearts, and His judgment and His statutes and His decrees, they would do them. His ways and His thinking would be established as a Torah written upon their minds, and they would think like Him. And I say that's me. I say that's you. I say the Holy Ghost has come to teach you. Quit listening to what everybody else is saying, because if you believe a lie, you'll be brought in bondage and you'll never be able to move with them. My grandmother read her the Bible. My grandmother's father was a preacher. His father was a preacher all the way back to the 1650s in the United States of America. She read the Bible through for the first time as a Quaker when she was 10 years old in a covered wagon going from Tennessee to Michigan. She loved the Lord with all of her heart, but one day I was with her and she was 82 years old, and she came out of the room. She came out shouting that Baptist, Dutch, Reformed Quaker came out of the back room just leaping as best an 82-year-old woman could leap, and shouting, and says, Jesus really does heal today. I said, like, it's about time, Grandma. I mean, 72 years later, a lie had held her in bondage for so many years. She got down on her knees at 82 years old in such pain. She said, Lord Jesus. If you really are the healer, like my son Philip preaches, then I'll ask you to come and touch your servant's body now. And Lord Jesus instantly, it took her 72 years to pray a simple prayer like that. Ha, ha, hallelujah. People, don't believe a lie. Don't believe all this stuff that you, two-thirds of you belongs to God and your soul is floating around somewhere and belongs to you. Myself belongs to God. My soul belongs to God. My mind, my ears, my nose, my teeth, my tongue, my toes, my legs, my knees, my elbows. Did I say that already? Every part of me. And anybody tells you differently, they didn't know what they're talking about. All they are is disciples of men. All they've learned, that they didn't learn it from God, the Holy Ghost, nor from His Word. They're just disciples of men. And it's held them in bondage. They're always talking about something that the enemy can then have wiggle room and access into their life through. Not me. I'm 100% branded. Kingdom of God purchased by the blood, body, soul, and spirit, preserved, blameless. Hallelujah. Let me help you with something. The Hebrew word for soul is nefesh. Say nefesh. Nefesh. The Greek word for soul is psuche. Say psuche. It means your whole being. That's what it means. That's it. Your whole being. It's the all-inclusive word. The only all-inclusive word for the whole being of man. And people trying to salve their iniquity and trying to make excuses for their sin and some reason for why they still have some kind of something going on that's not of God came up with crazy doctrines. I want you to denounce it, because as long as you hold on to that demon spirit, it will hold you back. And God's looking for an army that belongs completely to Him. Satan comes and has nothing in them. I'm following the ministry of Jesus. I'm going to look like Him, act like Him, be like Him, move like Him, follow Him in everything that He's doing. I'm not only born of the Spirit, I'm filled with the Spirit. I'm not only born of the Spirit, filled with the Spirit. I'm baptized in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has complete control over me. Somebody said, Mark, you're special. You've got a renewed mind. How did it happen? Give me a break. I just started thinking like God. I just stood in His presence. It's not like some special privileges. I just started believing what God said and said away with the doctrines of men. Every one of them. And I pray today you'll denounce every doctrine that's not like God. If it wasn't bought by the blood, it's forever damned. Because yes. You're not going to perfect anything of your life after you've been purchased by Him. Amen. Having begun in the Spirit, are you now made perfect by the human ability, by the flesh? Jesus was manifested in the flesh. The Gnostics hate it. Flesh for them is evil. Flesh for me is holy. I see it in Jesus Christ. And now you and I need to discipline ourselves. Get with a program, start looking, recognizing ourselves and giving all heed to making giving all diligence to making our calling and election sure. And go ahead and recognize that now that we have been made partakers of the divine nature and have escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust, that it doesn't belong to us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We add unto our faith virtue. Purity. I love walking in purity. It allows you to perfectly see. When you walk in purity, purity of mind, that's why I don't watch all this stuff that everybody else runs around watching. They think that somehow they're so special that they can take fire into their bosom and not be burned. Not me. I'm grieved by that stuff. I'm going to tell you right now, somebody said, oh, you're just so heavenly minded, you know earthly good. No, when you get fully heavenly minded, you'll be fully earthly good. I'm telling you right. You'll be, God has purpose. He predestinated you and I to be conformed to the image of Christ Jesus. That's what He predestinated us to be and to do. And I just want to teach you how to get happy in God, how to shout, how to move around, how to talk about Him all the time, how to talk about Him all the time, how to just be so, your spirit so united with the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of holiness. You love what He loves and hate what He hates. And you didn't have to try to work it out. He just wrote it upon me. It's the new age. It's the messianic age. The Messiah came. Crucified, buried, went down into hell. Rose up with keys of death and life. Was seen of many witnesses, about 500 for 40 days. Then ascended upon high. Having been coronated, having been exalted King of Kings over everything, a name above every name, over all principalities and powers and mights and every government and authority, both earthly and spiritual, He received from the Father the gift of the Holy Spirit and poured out upon you and me His same divine power and glory. Somebody said, restored back to Adam. No, way beyond. Fully inducted into all that God Himself would reproduce when He gave the seed of the Word. And if you begin to believe it like the old timers did, we'll begin to go back to Pentecost. We'll begin to go back to the holiness movement where God paid it all and did it all and we're His. In the holiness movement, a preacher's daughter wrote a song. She said, "Take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine." The consecration is called sanctification. It's not a second work of grace. It's a yieldedness to this place. It's an agreement with God. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you right now, sanctification will become a doctrine in the church again. Consecration to the holiness of God. He is holy, holy, holy. Take my heart. It is thine own. It's not where evil thoughts proceed forth from. It is thine own. It shall be your royal throne. The holies of holies moved from heaven into this earthly tabernacle of clay. Now that we are tabernacling in this wonderful glory that Abraham looked and saw far away, saying, we seek a kingdom whose builder and maker is God and have no here any long-lasting or certain dwelling place. We on a pilgrimage, hallelujah, tabernacling in the glory, in the Bosharafita Shekinah glory, the Holy Spiritiste Protofans, the Holy Ghost, the living God, hidden away in Him, the Father, in Christ Jesus. So tonight, we just want you to just get raptured away, and if all of a sudden, you know, Evangelist Richard is preaching, and you just got a burning prophecy, and you know it's going to take the thing to a, you're going to punch right through something in the spirit, just go ahead, just shout it out. Huh? We'll all know as soon as you're finished. What it added or took away. And it's okay, because that's the only way you're going to grow. Because God ordained that when you step in the church, everybody prophesies. And then now the secrets of the hearts of men are revealed, falling down in our midst. Hallelujah. They say God is in this place. We've had all the other things that supposedly would accommodate the move of the Spirit and hadn't done all that God has purposed for it to do. And so we praise God for everything that God's been doing, everything God's done in us. We just pressing in. Hallelujah. Come on, man. God's got, hey, Papa's got so much more for you. He wants you to know this love that passes knowledge and there be filled with all of His fullness down to Him who is able to do super abundantly above all that we can think or ask according to the power that's at work on the inside of us. We're good to go. Father's in control. Amen. Come on. Just do it. Just be faithful. Just be faithful. Tonight, as Evangelist Richard is preaching, I want you to, you know, let God lay upon your heart. Don't think about it. If you try to think too hard, God can't speak to you. Just be there waiting in the presence of the Lord. I'm seeding you right now so this plant can grow. Okay? Just waiting in the presence of the Lord. The Lord lays something specifically on your heart in which you want to share in their ministry. And this is usually the way I do it. This is the way I feel to do it. You know, and so this is just how the program goes. Most of you know it. And, you know, every bit of the offering, of course, goes to Richard. I don't mingle offerings. I don't do it. You're not going to ever be confused by the help and the grace of God about what you're giving to when I receive an offering. You know, I won't have it Richard me, Richard Abiding Place, or anything like that. And I know some people take up 7 offerings in a meeting. I don't figure I got to pump you that hard. You know what I'm saying? I figure you can get her done. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One time around. Amen. I figure you could give tonight as much as you would have given over the past 3 services. This would be the 3rd service of Richard's ministry. You can give as much tonight. You're going to get blessed. I'm going to get blessed. Church is going to get blessed. I think Richard's the first person that ever came and ministered for us that received an offering, gave it all back to me. I said, I'll take it back so long as I get credit and account in God for it. I knew what I was saying. I just want him to agree. And I love you so much, Richard. And Rhonda, we love you so much. Thank you, Jesus, for Rhonda. The Lord is going to lay something on your heart. You give it tonight. Okay? Whatever the Lord seeds you with, whatever He touches you with tonight. Amen.
Amen. Rorra mandele breso rande brebo so. Rebarriando romande chevramondo. Zelebre basusto rande brebaso. Mandele brebaseto rande lele brebasita. Ora nelle le brezza ande di avrabaseta. Ma
I have a number of things I want to share with you tonight, but I just want to just read this. And beloved, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us. Beloved, what manner of love the Father, everybody say the Father, hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God.
That's who we are.
Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. The world knoweth us not, because it knows him not. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knows him not. If the world knows you, you don't know him.
Right.
We are the family of God. Amen. No, we are the family of God.
Amen.
No, we are the family.
Yes.
We are the family. Woo. We are the family of God. No. Just let that get in your spirit. We are the family of God. Think about it. The very one who spoke and the world was. The very one who spoke and he created the sun. The very one who spoke and created the sea and filled the sea with all that's in there. The very one with his breath created the galaxies and all the stars there are. And then he names them.
Yeah.
He says that we are a part of his family.
Amen.
I guess we could title tonight's message, "Do You Know Who Your Daddy Is?" Who's your daddy? We are the family of God. And the world knows us not because they know him not. And yet we got people today that are so carnal. Their lives are founded upon doctrines of devils because their leader operates by familiar spirits, wants to try to be relevant to the world, to let the world know that we're like them, that we can cope. Get saved. My Bible says that if you're a friend of the world, you are an enemy of God. And I'm not his enemy. I'm his son. I am the redeemed of the Lord. My Redeemer lives. Do you know that we have a song that the angels can't even sing? Because they're not redeemed. But we are. Oh, you know how I know that you don't really understand that and have an understanding of that? Because if you really had a revelation of it, you wouldn't be able to sit still. We are the redeemed. That we are the family of God. We are the family of God. Chakanamoshita. No, you gotta let that get in your spirit. Oh, yeah, he's getting it. That's what happens when you get it. Oh, yeah.
Do you know, many years ago, I had a revival in Roanoke, Virginia. I was there for 3 weeks. And two services a day for 3 weeks. And there was this elderly Baptist pastor who started coming the first week of the revival. Shakarabasita. And so, I remember one of the weeks, he gets up, he comes every night. On the Wednesday night, I believe it was the last week, the third week, he goes to his church on Wednesday night, First Primitive Baptist, primitive. I don't even know what primitive means, what that means, what a primitive Baptist. I mean, First Baptist, those are the originals. He said, I'm Primitive Baptist. I'm like, okay. Yeah, whatever. And he got up on Wednesday night. He said, church, he said, I waited till y'all get here because we're going to dismiss tonight and we're all going to get in our vehicles because there ain't nothing happening here. And we're going to go down to such and such church because God's down there. And he dismissed his whole church and came to our meeting. And then at the end, in the end of the week, the last, I think, was he wasn't able to come the last night, but the last morning meeting, he came to me, I could still see, like it was 5 minutes ago, elderly man, white hair, white as snow. Very white, I mean, really, really white hair. And he came to me with tears in his eyes, been pastoring that Baptist, Primitive Baptist Church for 25 years. Primitive Baptist. We're primitive Holy Ghost. I mean, we're primitive whatever we are. I don't even know where. I just know I'm the family of God. That's all I care about. And he came to me with tears, Pastor, with tears coming down his eyes, crying almost like a baby. You know what he said to me? He said, son, he said, I regret pastoring this Baptist church for 25 years, that it took me 25 years. Take me all my life serving God, all my Baptist life, to realize that this was available, to experience this. Don't take this for granted, church. There's people crying out for this. People all over the world crying out to be able to come and to be a part of a church like this, to be a part of a meat service like this. But we're the family of God. Yeah. Do you know when you're born of a family, that means you got the same DNA. That means you got the same nature. Come on.
That's correct.
You got the same nature. You got the same. Do you know the very life of God is your life?
That's my life.
Do you know the very life of God is your life?
Yeah.
No, the very life of God. God's life. Is your life. No, God's life is your life. No, you're not getting it. God's life is your life. And the moment you come into an understanding of that, all sickness and disease will go. Because death can't reign where his life is. No, death can't reign where his life is. No, death can't reign where his life is.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, my wife and I have been since Well, I've been in ministry 31 years, but I don't count the first 5 years. Nothing happened. I mean, why can't years where, I mean, you give altar calls and nobody answers? I don't even want to go back to them days. I don't even want to think about it. Have miracle crusades with no miracles. 5 years. When I did that for 5 years, it took me 5 years to realize there's a problem. So 20, I just count from 1990, so 26 years. Do you know what? This is how we've been living for 26 years. And I tell you, the Lord gave me a message tonight to share with you. Amen. And the message started a long time ago. I'm going to go over to this section. The message started a long time ago. You know, we're just tapping into heaven. No, we're just tapping into heaven. No, we're just tapping in. You know, when you tap into the realm of the realm of God, when you tap, step. Oh yeah. You know what you do? You step over into that river that flows from the throne of God. And the Bible says in that river, anybody who gets in that river lives. Amen. So I don't care what it is you're facing. Just come stand by the bank and turn around. Let me take my foot and push you in the river. Because you'll live. Because whoever gets in will live. I have a dear friend of mine with me here tonight, Pastor Pastor Mike Gates, all the way from Kilmarnock, Virginia. Lives in a town about 5,000. And if you go to with, I think there's one traffic light. Is there one traffic light in your city or two? There's four. Wow, you're growing. But I mean, the town's so small that if you come up to the traffic light and there's three cars there, I mean, it's a traffic jam. I mean, and so he's come all the way here to be with us tonight. And thank you, my brother, for being coming. Just stand up, just so people can, so California can celebrate you. Hallelujah. You know, the Lord's using him in a mighty way. You know, he's the Lord touched him. The fire of God came on him a number of years ago, and he used to be a raging, angry man, drunk. He was, and it's his testimony. But the fire of God came on him, and you know, there's no case, there's nobody beyond the fire.
None.
The river of God began to flow in him. Totally delivered him. The demons left him. And now he's got a church, and the Lord's using him mightily in the jails. He goes through all of the jails. And then none of the prisoners in there, they all know about Pastor Mike. Because when he goes into the jails, the power of God hits the people. Now, it's amazing. His jail is full of Christians. His Christian.
His church.
No, his jail's not full of Christians. I admit that didn't come out right. Sheesh. You should come stand where I'm standing. You should come stand in what I'm standing in. His church is full of ex-prisoners. That where he came into, the fire of God hit him and totally delivered him. Power of God hits him in the jail. Now, nobody, the religious people used to go there and nothing would happen. They didn't even want to see him. But now he goes because he carries the glory of God with him. Because he had an encounter with God. And remember, Jeremiah says that wherever you go, he'll go. He goes into the jails. Guess what? And the power of God hits him. And God's using him mightily in the jails. Hallelujah. Amen. But that's our job, to go on the highways, the byways, the jails. Come on. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Do you know there's a lot of hurting people?
Yes.
That right now all over San Diego, more than you realize, yep, with a gun to their head.
Yeah.
One day in their life, because they're tormented and afflicted, and yet the whole time, the answer to their life, the freedom to their life, the liberty to their life is here. That's why we have to go. That's why we have to go.
Yes.
Do you know when the Lord told us to go into all the world? You know that's the Great Commission. That's not the Great Suggestion. The Great Commandment. And then my precious, lovely wife. I've been married for 28 years. Hallelujah. We do this. This is what we've been doing for. Hallelujah. And I want to, I'm gonna share for you. Hallelujah. I just kept hearing all over in. Hallelujah. You know the same thing that's here tonight, the same presence, the same fire, the same glory that's here tonight is the very same glory that fell upon me that morning in January of 1990. Changed my whole life. So that very thing that changed my life that morning is here, right here tonight. You do not have to leave here like you've come. You do not have to leave here like you come. No, you don't have to leave here like you come. Tonight you can leave with an encounter. Tonight you can leave here, because the reality is there's actually angels in the house tonight with gifts that are being handed out from the Father. You don't have to leave like you came. Hallelujah. Who's that mic? Hallelujah. Who's the mic? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. This is my precious, come here, sweetie. Hallelujah. Just greet the people, pray, prophesy. What? Hallelujah. Preach.
Well, hallelujah. Woo! Woo! I like it when we go into a place and we don't have to prime the pump. I like it when we don't have to find somebody a cup. I like it. You know, the Bible says, know ye not that ye are the temple of the Holy Ghost. You're filled with praise. You're filled with power. You're overflowing. You know, it's the power and the demonstration. Woo! You know, Paul that wrote 3/4 of the New Testament, he says, I don't come with enticing words of man's wisdom, but of power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost. We are Holy Ghost people, and we have a big God that wants to move in our midst. And when we get out of the way, He can have His way. Amen? Woo! I know for many, many years we would travel and I would just sit there and I'd get full and full and full and full, because you know, when you start getting full, you're going to overflow and something's going to happen. Something's going to happen tonight to you. Something's going to happen, because the power of God is in the house. The anointing is in the house. The river of God is flowing in this place, and something's going to happen. Is it going to happen to you? Are you open to receive that river, that higher dimension, that anointing that destroys the yoke of bondage from off of thy neck? Is that you? So I would sit in these meetings, and sometimes we'd go into a church, and it's like, whoo, whoo, it's like the Antarctic. And I'm like, oh, dear Jesus, let's get some fire in the house. I'm like, oh, my gosh, I'm made for the third week of those revivals. That first week, it's just like, ka-choo, ka-choo. You're just trying to bang on that wall. You know, my husband, he has this wonderful sermon. He talks about that damn wall. You know, there's always a wall that holds the river of God from flowing. And you know, just know that if you've got walls, which I don't think a lot of you do after that worship, worship, but if you do, if some are still left, just know that there's cracks. And as the word of God goes forth, it's like, and as the preaching, and as the anointings and the Holy Spirit is walking up and down the aisles, it's like, and just know that it's leaving. Amen? Woo! It's leaving tonight. It's leaving tonight. You're going to leave different than when you came in. You know? I used to say, I'm going to get everything that I can get. So don't get your brother's blessing tonight. Because you know the anointing is present to bring a change in your life. It's to bring a change in your mindset. The Bible says that we have the mind of Christ. Let this mind be in you. You have the mind of Christ. Amen? So just know that he's going to tweak you tonight. So I'm just going to read this scripture because this is what it is. This is what it is. I was just like, woo! I like when the Spirit is moving and then God just gives you the scripture that confirms the Spirit that was moving because the Word and the Spirit agree. Come on. The Word and the Spirit agree. If you just have all word, 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 you dry up. Woo, you get crusty. Yeah, you're like a raisin. Come on. You know what a raisin, A raisin was a juicy grape. So I'm looking at juicy grapes. Amen. And this is found in Colossians 2. And I'm just going to read it and then I'm going to hand it over to my husband. It says, as you have therefore received Christ, even Jesus the Lord, so walk, regulate your lives and conduct yourselves in union with and conformity to him. Have the roots of your being. Say roots.
Roots.
My being. Firmly and deeply planted in him, fixed and founded in him, being continually built up in him, becoming increasingly more confirmed. Say, I'm being more confirmed. And established in the faith. Just as you were taught and abounding and overflowing in with thanksgiving. See to it that no one carries you off as spoil or makes you yourselves captive by his so-called philosophy, intellectualism, and vain deceit, idle fancies, and plain nonsense. Follow after human tradition, men's ideas of the material rather than the spiritual word. Just crude nonsense. Crude notions. Follow. The Bible says you don't add to it, you don't take it away. But I've just added a word. So I know it says crude notions. You know, when you're sewing, you have notions in your little sewing kit. And there's all kinds of things in that sewing kit. And you know, there's all kinds of fangs and creatures in the body of Christ. And God doesn't want us to be easily carried away with every wind of doctrine. He wants us rooted and firmly founded and grounded on his word. Hallelujah. So just know, as we are people of his word and people of his pasture, we have been made in his image and he created us for his pleasure. He wants to pleasure you tonight in his presence. And as you open up and allow him to come and pleasure you, you know, he wants to go deep, deeper than you've gone, you know, deeper than you've ever seen, deeper in the realm of glory. The Bible says from glory to glory to glory. So obviously we need to taste and see that the Lord is good. His mercy endureth forever. So you step over tonight into a deeper realm of glory and you just open up and say, Holy Spirit, I am yours. Holy Spirit, take me to the deep waters tonight. We're going to the deep waters tonight. Take us there. Come on. Lead us there so we can drink.
Hallelujah.
We can.
Hallelujah. I promise you, what's here tonight, I promise you, far better than those that are in the bars down the street. I promise you. Amen. In the morning, you'll wake up free. You'll wake up filled. You'll wake up delivered. Come on, you'll wake up with a song. Hallelujah. You know, Hallelujah. I look so forward every year. I mean, coming here is a very high water mark for my life every year. And if Pastor would ever say no, I'd be like crushed. Just because I love coming and hang out with this precious, precious couple. This couple is so dear to my heart, and I love them very, very much. And not just about coming to church, just to hang out with him. And iron sharpens iron, you know. And it's just so precious, such a precious people. And then the church, you know, we love you guys. I feel like I'm such a part of this church. I feel like this is my home. I really do. I feel like this is my home. You know, some places I go to, I'm like, Lord, don't send me there. Then other places I go to, like here, it's like, Lord, can I move here? And because we just feel such a part. And, you know, that's the good thing about the social media. You know, it really is. That's the good thing about it, is that I feel such a part. You know, I see Allie and Joshua and what's going on in their lives. And, you see our post and with Pastor Mark and then others. And I see Catherine right there and Crystal and Lawrence and others here. You know, I mean, just you feel a part of what's going on. And, you know, we're doing a camp meeting. I'm doing a camp meeting and want you to come next year in Greensboro, North Carolina. Pastor Mark's going to come and be one of the Holy Ghost fire preachers that's going to come. And so we want you to come. And we should do one here, too, like me and you and Tim. We should do one here. And yeah. Hallelujah. Amen. How do you think we should do a camp meeting here? He's thinking nothing like pressure. I mean, no, but no, I do. I love it. I was telling Pastor Mark, I love it. I'm telling Pastor Mark, Pastor Mike, I mean, we're driving. I'm like, I can live here. I can just live here. I mean, I don't really know why. I think it's just because of just how much I love the Spitsbergens and the family here and of course Geneva and Emily. I just feel I feel at home. I really do. And so I want you to know we love you dearly, and it's such an honor to be here with you. And it really, really is the high water mark of the year when we were able to come and be here with you guys. Whew. I love you, man. I love you, man. I tell you, the Lord is so good, isn't he? Oh, my. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah. The Lord is so good. I tell you what's on my heart tonight, and I don't know how far we're going to get to it, but I kept talking about it, thinking about it. I just kept hearing these words, glory. 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 You know, and as I think about what the Lord's been saying to me about tonight, and really I see why we went the direction we went this morning. Oh, hallelujah. But glory. Because we do go from the cross to glory. Amen. We do go from the cross. It all begins at the cross. But from the cross to Pentecost. But we don't stop there either. We go on into glory. Amen. As my wife said, we go from glory to glory to glory to glory to glory. I mean, from glory to glory to glory to glory. Listen, next year, if when we come back, if you're at the same place next year where you are now, something's wrong. But you won't be. No, you won't be. From glory to glory to glory. No, from glory to glory to glory. From glory to glory to glory. Amen? From glory. You know, I see the same thing Pastor Mark said. You know, you hear people say, hey, you just don't want to be so heavenly minded, no earthly good. Oh, no, you do. That's the problem. That's the problem in the church. We got too many earthly minded people. Hello? See, earthly minded people don't cast out devils. They counsel them.
And that's what you do, and that's what churches do today. They forget about casting out devils. They don't cast out devils anymore. They counsel them. And then they pay. Pay me. No, I'm serious. They don't even talk about sin anymore in the church. They don't even talk about they don't because they don't want to mention sin. You know what? They've even changed the name of sin. You know, many, many churches don't even call sin anymore. You know what they call it? Issues. Well, well, you know, they got issues. No, it's called S-I-N. And I'm going to share something with you. Woo! It's going to make you dance. You know why people sin? Because they're not satisfied with God.
Right.
It's true.
When you're satisfied with God, when you just taste. All it takes is just one taste. No, just one. My mom said it earlier. Taste and see that He's good. That's all. Just one taste. The last thing you'll ever want to ever do in your life is sin, because you've tasted of Him. It's amazing how people are going to justify. But I'm starting to get into some of my message, but because the Lord said, I kept hearing these words, glory, glory, glory. But also the Lord also took me, and I don't know how we're going to fit it in if we do. But also the Lord took me just right before the service. I love it when He just gives it to me right away. He takes me to Jeremiah. Well, I'll tell you what, just go there. Go to Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 2. Here's the condition. Jeremiah chapter 2. Father, tonight we so glorify You. We so glorify You tonight, Lord. We worship You. 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 Look at this. And here's the condition of the church today. Verse 1. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, thank God for the word of the Lord. Amen. No, thank God for the word of the Lord.
Amen.
No, thank God for the word of the Lord.
Amen.
No, thank God for the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, go and cry in the ears of Jerusalem, saying, thus saith the Lord, I remember thee, the kindness of thy youth, the love of thy espousals, when thou wentest after me in the wilderness and in the land that was not sown. Israel was holiness unto the Lord, and the first fruits of his increase. All that devour him shall offend. Evil shall come upon them, saith the Lord. Now go jump down to verse 8. The priest said, where is the Lord? And they that handled the law knew me not. The pastors also transgressed against me, and the prophets prophesied by Baal and walked after the things that do not profit. Everybody say, do not profit. And Pastor and I have been talking just about some of the stuff. And actually, as we've been talking, the Lord gave me this scripture. And this is the very thing that's going on in many churches around the country tonight.
True.
They've gotten involved in things that do not profit. They've gotten involved, and I'm going to show you why. Verse 9, wherefore I will yet plead with you, saith the Lord, and with your children's children will I plead. For pass over the isles of Chittim and see, and send unto Kedar, and consider diligently and see if there be such a thing. Listen, verse 11, hath a nation changed their gods, which are yet no gods, but my people have changed their glory for that which doeth not profit. For my people have changed their glory for that which doeth not profit. Be astonished, O ye heavens, at this, and be horribly afraid. Be ye very desolate, saith the Lord, for my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken the fountain of living waters, and whom them out cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water.
Lord.
You know what a cistern is? A cistern is a giant cistern that holds water. It contains the water. But they've hewn themselves out cisterns that can hold no water because they've changed their glory. They've committed two evils. And they've accepted into their life, into their abiding, that which doeth not profit. Because they get caught up in the very thing that's called, it's really demonic. For once the glory of God was present.
Yep.
But what happens along the way, they bring in that which God's not in, and God won't share His glory. They bring in that which God's not in, and they begin to accept that more than they do God. And they come to the place to where God's gone. And they've changed their glory for that which doeth not profit. And you go to some of the churches today around the country and around the world, and they cry out that it's the Lord, but the Lord's not in it. They cry out that it's God, but God's not in it. Because they've changed the glory of God for that which profiteth not. And they prophesy by familiar spirits, and they do things by demon spirits. And yet we have Christians today that can't even tell the difference between that which is holy and that which is evil. And you raise up, just listen to modern day Christian music. And people don't even know if it's anointed. People say it's anointed, but there's no anointing on it. People are writing these songs and making huge money because really that's the bottom line what it's about.
Yeah.
I mean, you can tell the people writing the songs, it's not even scriptural. They don't even have a word base. Hello? I don't mean for it to get so quiet here tonight. I'm saying all this because we have to be very careful.
Yes.
That's why we have to stay in the Word.
Yes. Yes.
No, we have to stay in the Word. You'll never go wrong by staying with the Word.
Yes. Right.
You'll never go wrong with staying with the Word. You know, we have a, and I think it's because of my mentor. I think because he put it in me, Dr. Kenneth Hagin. He put it in me and just put it in me. He, the saying that he always said just drilled in me to me. If it's not in the Word, don't do it. If it's not in the Word, don't accept it. No, if it's not. And then you got people going around accepting all this stuff because it's progressive revelation. No, it's demons.
Yeah.
No, it's demons. And they're going around laying on the dead, on the grave of dead saints. No, I'm serious. Do you know, it's so stupid. If they would just learn to worship Him and get into the glory, what they need is in the glory. Not laying on the grave of some dead man. Hello, everything you need is in His presence.
Yes.
No, everything you need, everything that I've gotten because of His presence.
Yes.
Everything that's in me came from His presence.
It's true.
That's why I can go anywhere and have revival. I've proved it. All 44 nations of the world have moves of God. Almost every state in America have a move of God. Why? Because it's in me.
Yes.
Right.
It's not on a piece of paper. Preachers need to understand, Bible school students need to understand, your ministry is not your sermon, your ministry is what's in here.
Yeah.
It's what's in here. And when it's in here, you can go anywhere and have a move of God.
anywhere and have a move of God. Do you know what? There's no place that's hard. There's no place that's hard. I've had preachers tell me, "Ooh, don't want to go up there, it's hard." I don't even know what that means. That's a foreign word to me. No, I'm serious. That is a foreign word to me, hard. No, it's only hard when you don't have anything. Let me say it over to this section. It's only hard when you don't have anything.
Yeah.
I've had people say for years, "Oh, it's hard in New England." I found some of the greatest revivals in New England. I remember we was in one church in New England. I was only going to be there 3 days. Ended up being there. The pastor had come. I mean, the glory of God came in the house. The pastor said, "Well, let's go on Thursday and Friday." Power of God hit in the place. The pastor said, "Well, let's go on next week." Power of God hit the place. At the beginning of the second week, I didn't know there was a reporter that came. The Concord Monitor, it's a major newspaper that goes all over New England. It's not like a community newspaper. It's like the New York Times or whatever, LA, whatever, Times, whatever it is called. And I don't read it. I'm like Smith and Wigglesworth. I don't want lies in my house. Do you know, Lester Sumrall, I'm very good friends with Frank Sumrall, which is Lester Sumrall's oldest son. And I asked Frank some questions. So I always heard about these things, about what Lester did. And before I tell people, I want to know if it's the truth. Because I'm going to stand before God and give an account of everything I say.
Right.
You know I'm going to stand before God and give an account of tonight, what I tell you?
Yes.
And I said to him, "Was it true about your dad when he went to see Lester, when your dad Lester went to Saul Smith and Wigglesworth?" He said it was everything was the truth. Because you hear about when Lester Sumrall went to see Smith Wigglesworth, who was raised 26 people from the dead. Do you know he would go to Bible schools? Do you know he would go to seminaries? And he would beg the students to come and hang out with him in his house. Do you know nobody would come? Think about what was in that man that could have got into a bunch of other people if they was just hungry. See, it's amazing what you do when you're hungry, but it's also amazing what people do when they're not hungry. They do nothing. And he said he went to him. He's just a young boy, 18 years old. Knocked on the Wigglesworth door. Wigglesworth opened the door. He didn't say, "Welcome, young man," or "How you doing, son? Come on." First thing he said to him, he hollered at him. He said, "What's that underneath your arm?" And it was a newspaper. He's like, "It's strong." He said, "Well, it's a newspaper." He shouted, "Throw it out! Throw it out now! I don't allow lies in my house." What he did. And then he comes and sit down. He threw it in the bushes and he came and sit down. Wigglesworth, come fellowship with me. He sat down. Wigglesworth sat down. Lester sat down in the chair across the from him. And Wigglesworth opened up his Bible and read his Bible out loud for an hour. Then he prayed out loud for an hour. Then after he got done praying, he looked at Lester. He said, "Thank you for coming and fellowshipping with me today. Come back again." It was his fellowship. But he said something was obviously different about him. He said almost every day he'd go to his house for 3 months until the war started. He said I never ate a hot meal at Wigglesworth House. He said I'd go there and we'd go to sit down for a meal. Wigglesworth, his prayer over the meal was the book of Ephesians. He said that we'd sit down at the table, that his daughter would serve a hot meal. Wigglesworth would pray, open up the book of Ephesians, read the whole book of Ephesians. He said, "Never one time did I eat a hot meal." Or he'd pray for a half hour, or an hour, just pray. Now you get some insight in why he did the things he did.
Fellowship.
It's amazing. It's amazing when you start getting on the inside to see why people do what they do. It's always because they know God and they love him and they're passionate about him. He's everything. They want nothing but him.
Right.
They want nothing but him.
That's us.
One time, George, a man by the name of George Stallmart was driving him. He used to drive him sometimes. And he told the story. I heard him tell the story on tape. I heard him tell it. He said, one day we're driving down the road. I'm driving Smith Wigglesworth somewhere. And he said, "I'm driving." He said, "We had a long, many-hour drive." He said, "We're driving down the road." He said, after about 15, 20 minutes, maybe a half hour,
all of a sudden, he startled me. George said, Wigglesworth startled me, because Wigglesworth shouted, "Stop! Stop the car now! Stop! Stop!" He startled him. He pulls over. He says, "What's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong?" He said, "I looked over and I'm asking Wigglesworth what's wrong." He said, Wigglesworth bowed his head and tears coming down his cheeks. And he began to repent and said, "Father, forgive us, for we've gone 20 minutes and haven't talked about you." And he said, for the next 4 hours, Wigglesworth just read his Bible out loud for the next 4 hours. So you get some insight into why great men do great things.
It's true.
Then Lester went to see him one last time. And he goes to see him. He had, because the Americans were making all the Americans come back because the war began. And he goes to Wigglesworth and said, "I have to leave." Do you know, Lester said in 3 months that I'd go see him almost every day. Never one time did he have a visitor. And yet he would give the invitation to all these Bible school students and all these seminary students to come visit him. But he said that Wigglesworth prayed for him. Here's what he said. And I've talked to Frank about it. Exactly happened like this. Wigglesworth, he was just a tall man. He prayed for Lester. Lester was a short man about my height. He prayed for him and he laid his hands on him, and Wigglesworth began to say this. He began to say, "Father," he said, "let that which is upon me come into this young man." And he began to prophesy about the coming revival. And he said, "I could feel tears rolling off his cheeks, falling to my forehead." And he said, "Father, let that which you've given me come to this young man." And he said, I left, never saw him again. He said, I walked out the door, shut the door behind me, walked down the steps, opened the gate, walked out, shut the gate behind me, and I began to walk down the sidewalk. And when I began to walk down the sidewalk, all of a sudden something came, hit me. And he said, it hit me so hard, it took me up in the air. And he realized what it was. Just seconds ago, Wigglesworth prayed, "Lord, let that which you've given me come to this young man." And that day it was imparted into him. Think about all those students that had an invitation. See, but it comes down to this. How bad do you want it? How hungry are you?
Yeah.
How hungry are you? How hungry are you? How hungry are you? Some people are hungry for that which doeth not profit. For they got things going on in the service that they cry, "It's God, God," but God is nowhere around it. God's not even near it. I said to some guy just the other day on the telephone, the pastor called me just a couple days ago, called me about something breaking out somewhere, and he called me about it, and he told me what's going on. I said, "Well, let me tell you who my rule is. My rule is, if it's not in the Word of God," because I got it from my mentor, "if it's not in the Word of God, I don't want anything to do with it. If I can't find Jesus," think about it. It's Jesus who had the anointing of God without measure. We have it by measure. He had it without measure. Now you can tap into that that the power that has no limits. It's actually in us. But you know, he had the anointing without measure. And some of the stuff that people say is going on in the service, if it was going to happen with anybody, we'd see it in the Word with Jesus, because he had the anointing without measure.
Yeah.
If I can't see it upon Jesus, who had the anointing of God without measure, I don't want it.
Amen.
If I can't find it happening with the early church, I don't even like to use that term early church. I don't like that term early church, because we're the same church.
Right.
And sometimes when you use that term early church, it's almost like you put them in a category separate. We're separate. No, 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 we're the same church.
Right.
Same purpose, same mission, same Holy Ghost, same Father. Hello.
Yes.
Same church.
Yes.
But yet you look with the early church, if it's not happening with them, I don't want it. Stay with the Word.
Amen.
Go with me, if you would, to your Bibles, to the book of Acts, please. Acts chapter 7. Actually, go with me to, first off, I'm going to read a number of scriptures. Go with me to Exodus chapter 16. Glory to glory to glory. Exodus 16, verses 7 and 10. Now, just you can write these down and let these get on the inside of you. Exodus 16, 7 and 10. And in the morning you shall see the glory of the Lord. For that he heareth your murmurings against the Lord. Verse 10, and it came to pass as Aaron spake unto the whole congregation of the children of Israel, that they looked toward the wilderness, and behold, the glory of the Lord appeared in a cloud. Exodus chapter 40. Exodus chapter 40, verse 34. Then a cloud covered the tent of the congregation, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. And Moses was not able to enter into the tent of the congregation because the cloud abode thereon, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. Leviticus chapter 9. Leviticus chapter 9, verse 4, verse 6, and verse 23. Also, a bullock and a ram for peace offerings to sacrifice before the Lord, and a meat offering mingled with oil, for the day of the Lord will appear unto you. And verse 6, and Moses said, this is the thing which the Lord commanded that you should do. And the glory of the Lord, everybody say glory of the Lord. And the glory of the Lord shall appear unto you. Verse 23, and Moses and Aaron went into the tabernacle of the congregation and came out and blessed the people. And the glory of the Lord appeared unto all the people. Numbers chapter 14, verse 10. But all the congregation bade stone them with stones. And the glory of the Lord appeared in the tabernacle of the congregation before all the children of Israel. Verse chapter 20, verse 6. Numbers chapter 20, verse 6. And Moses and Aaron went from the presence of the assembly unto the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. And they fell upon their faces, and the glory of the Lord appeared unto them. 1 Kings chapter 8, verses 10 and verse 11. And it came to pass, when the priests were come out of the holy place, that the cloud filled the tabernacle of the Lord. Verse 11, so that the priest could not stand to minister because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house of the Lord. Actually, one translation reads that the priest could not stand to function or continue on in their ministerial duties because the glory of the Lord had filled the house. 2 Chronicles chapter 5, verses 11 through 14. And it came to pass when the priest were come out of the holy place, for all the priests that were present were sanctified and did not then wait by course. Also the Levites, which were the singers, and all of them of the Asaph and Heman and Jeduthun, with their sons and their brethren, being arrayed in white linen, having cymbals and psalteries and harps, and stood at the east end of the altar, and with them 120 priests sounding with trumpets. And it came to pass, verse 13, and it came to pass, as the trumpeters and singers were as one, to make one sound to be heard in the praising and thanking the Lord. And when they lifted up their voice with the trumpets and cymbals and instruments of music, and praised the Lord, saying, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. That then, listen, the house was filled with a cloud, even the house of the Lord, so that the priest could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house of God. One more, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verses 1 and 2. Now when Solomon had made an end of praying, the fire came down from heaven. Say, the fire came down from heaven. The fire came down from heaven and consumed the burnt offering and the sacrifices, and the glory of the Lord filled the house, and the priest could not enter into the house of the Lord because the glory of the Lord had filled the Lord's house. Go two more verses. Let's go over to the New Testament. Go over to the New Testament. In Acts chapter 7. Acts chapter 7, verse 55. But when he, Stephen, who's the first martyr, being full of the Holy Ghost, looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing on the right hand of God. One more scripture. Go with me to the book of Ephesians chapter 1. Ephesians, the first chapter. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, now listen, the Father of glory. The Father of glory. I'll read the rest. May give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of Him. Understand something. The glory of God all throughout the world. Listen, that's just a smidgen of scriptures. I could have read a whole lot more. But all throughout the Word of God, you see that the glory of the Lord would come, that the glory of the Lord would appear. Actually, in Exodus 40, actually, I didn't read it all, but if we would keep reading, the Bible says that when the cloud began to move, the children of Israel began to move. When the cloud stayed put, then guess what? They stayed put. They set up camp. But when the cloud began to move, they'd begin to move with the cloud. Understand something. We have to move with God.
Yes.
We have to move with God.
Amen.
We have to follow Him. Because as long as you're following Him and as long as you're moving with the cloud, you will not accept that which doeth not profit. You will not accept that which is not of God. And you will not get off into that which is not of God. And you will not allow that into your assembly. You won't be following after manifestations. You know we're never to follow after manifestations. But manifestations should accompany us everywhere we go. Understand, He is glory. He is the God of glory. And we can't handle all of His glory. Our body wouldn't be able to handle it all. We'd be consumed. That's why we're going to need glorified bodies in heaven. But you know, but we can experience the glory of God here in this life. We can experience and walk in the glory of God in His life. And if you would just hunger and thirst for Him, you would find that you would meet Him. You would have a face-to-face meeting with Him. And that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, He would not just be someone that you have information about, but He would be somebody that you have a relationship with. And He's your Father. And He's the God of glory. And He wants you to come up higher. Come up higher. Come up higher. Come up higher. Chakarifa rupasita. Come up higher. For He is glory. Now He is glory. He is glory. Now if you notice that when we read those scriptures, you see cloud. You see fire. But you know, it was the cloud of glory that protected the children of Israel during the day. And it was the fire of God, the cloud, the glory of God, the fire of God that protected them during the night. Do you know the children of Israel knew that as long as they were in the glory, they were provided for. As long as they were in the glory, manna came down from heaven. If the children of Israel would have just decided, I'm tired of moving all the time. I'm tired of following its cloud. You know, if they just decided, I'm just going to stay put, get stubborn. I'm just going to stay put. You know what? The cloud would not stay. The cloud would continue to go. God would continue to move. And if they just decided they're going to camp out, they died.
Right.
And we got those today. We have a generation today that's come about that knows nothing about the glory of God. I remember one time when the Lord Jesus appeared to my mentor. You know what Jesus said to him? He said, my church knows a little bit about praising me, but nothing about worshiping me. Because worship isn't just coming, you know, come from the hymn book or just come and sing. No, 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 no. All of our worship, everything should, everything we do is the church. Everything we do should be Spirit-led. Everything we do should be that which is done by the Holy Ghost. And we just hook up with Him. Even the announcements. Everything done by the Holy Ghost. Because where the Holy Ghost is, there's life. Where the Holy Ghost is, there's freedom. When the Holy Ghost is, there's liberty.
Amen.
Don't follow after that which is popular. Don't follow after that which some Christian leaders are going after. Stay with the glory. Stay with the Holy Ghost. I remember the very first time I saw the glory of God. It was in Daytona Beach, Florida. I was in a meeting. And I remember I saw the glory of God come in. I got to be careful because sometimes I begin to talk about it. If your eyes would just be open in the realm of the Spirit, you see the glory of God here right now.
Right.
Not only would you see the glory of God here, guess what? You'd see your miracles here.
Yeah.
Because your miracle's present. You just got to get it from the realm of the Spirit and bring it to this natural. And I remember in the glory of God. I remember the glory of God. I begin to see it wave like it was like a morning. I don't know if it's like a foggy morning. You know, there's not words to describe it. I don't have in my Kentucky vocabulary words to describe it. But I remember when the glory of God began to come in. I remember there was this one girl. She didn't want to be there. She was mad. She was stood in the service the whole time, mad, and just makes these faces and mad at her mom because you can tell that her parents made her come. But oh, I could tell, but that's the glory of God. I watched it with my eyes, the eyes of my spirit, and the natural and in the spirit. I watched the glory of God come in. When the glory of God come in, when it came on, it is just like the cloud. God, come. Oh, It developed her. She began to weep like a baby. She ran to the altar. I remember another time in Louisville, Kentucky. The church that I got saved in. 5,000 member church, Louisville, Kentucky. Colonel Sanders was a member of the church. Kentucky Fried Chicken. Do you know Colonel Sanders was a Holy Ghost man, spoke in tongues? That's why every time, have you ever wondered when you go eat Kentucky Fried Chicken, you just wanted to speak in tongues? That's why. It's Holy Ghost chicken. You know what I mean? And I remember in one night, I'm in the meeting, and I was got up behind the platform that night, the pulpit, whatever it is. And I remember as I stood, I opened up from Exodus 40 and began to read about the cloud. Oh, and the cloud came. You see it come from the balcony. It's like so rolling in. The cloud came. I tell you, the cloud came. And it was amazing. As the cloud came into that church, people started dancing. People started running. I mean, people started screaming. One man, I remember seeing this one man. He was sitting. There was an aisle going in the middle of the church, and he was sitting in the end of the first row. And this lady was standing in front of him. The glory of God came. And it's like fire, liquid fire hit her. And she jumped up. Ah! Started screaming. And then the guy, I watched it. The guy's eyes got big. I think he was a visitor. The guy's eyes got so big. And he jumped up and took off running to leave. and he was leaving. But he didn't know if he did just turn. There was a door right there, but he was in such a panic, he ran around the whole church trying to find a door. But I watched it. It's like everything came into slow motion. And as he finds it, I saw as he found the door, I promise you this happened. As he's running, it's like he goes into slow motion. I promise you, I'll never forget it. It's like he goes into slow motion, and he goes to touch the door, and he freezes. He went into a trance like this. Then he starts to shake it. No, I promise you. The glory of God. The glory of God. We are glory people. Our God is the God of our Lord Jesus Christ. He is the Father of glory. And we are sons of the Father of glory. We are sons of the God of glory. We are glory people. We are glory people. We live in the supernatural. We walk in the realms of God. We don't walk as the world walks. We don't fear as the world fears, because our trust is in the God that's more than enough. Our trust is in our Lord Jesus. Our trust is in the God of the Father of glory. What is there to fear? Though everything falls and crumbles around us, what is there to fear? Absolutely nothing. We're glory people. 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 Chaka. That night, that same night that man froze, there was another lady. The power of God came on her. She went into a trance. See, I can show you all this in the Bible. She went into a trance. She went into a trance. This lady, in that same meeting, as the glory of God came, the same glory that's here right now, the glory of God came, and she went into a trance for not 30 minutes, for not an hour, for not 2 hours, for 3 hours, for not one day, not 2 days, not even 3 days. For 4 days, this happened in our meeting. For 4 days, this lady is in a trance. Didn't drink any food, or didn't eat any food. Didn't eat any food, didn't drink any water, nothing, for 4 days. Matter of fact, the pastor started freaking out because I think of the third or maybe the first day, I think it was the first day, then like the third day, we was playing golf, and he said, "What am I doing? She's froze. She hasn't moved. What? I said, she's fine. Let's see it." Then he calls me the second day. She's still like that. The third day, she's still like that. Fourth day, she's still like that. She come out the fourth day, and he had her the next week, or maybe two, but he had her begin to testify what happened. And as she began to testify, because she said as she was in the trance, she saw Jesus, and as she began to testify about it, started happening again. Glory. No, glory. The glory of God. The glory of God. We are glory people. We are glory people. Because our Father is the Father of glory. We're glory people. No, we're glory people. No, we're glory people. That same glory that took Jesus up is the same glory that's here right now. That same glory that brought the children of Israel out of Egypt is the same glory that's here right now. That same glory that was a pillar of fire by night and a pillar of cloud by day is the same glory that's here right now. Yeah! See, because what I see still there. Because we, well, ha, ha, ha.
I feel it. I feel it. I'm about ready to take off. Sheesh. I'm about ready to take off. My. Oh! See, I'm not in the natural. I'm not a dancer, really. I can't dance. I mean, I just. You don't want to see me dance. Because yeah, Pastor goes, we saw it. Yeah. You know, I don't. Listen. I'm Kentucky hillbilly. I don't have it. It's not there. But oh, when the Holy Ghost, but as times the Holy Ghost come on me, the fire of God hit me, I start dancing in the Holy Ghost. You can't teach it. You just got to do it.
Yeah.
I can't teach you how. You just do it. You just. Yeah. I tell you, it's like, whoo, I feel it. It's like your feet's talking in tongues. Glory to God. And you just, oh, my. Shaka. It's the glory. Oh, it's the glory. Oh, it's the glory. It's the glory. That's the glory. I'm just trying to. It's the glory. 4 days she's in a trance. I cannot tell you the times we've gone to churches, because since 1990, everywhere we've gone, the meetings go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 weeks, 2 services. For 20 some years, we do almost 500 meetings a year. I've done for 1990, my wife and I, we've conducted about nearly 8,000 revivals. And I feel like I'm just learning. Because how can you exhaust? You know you can never exhaust him. How can you exhaust the one who has no beginning and has no end? I mean, if he was on an island and the only thing, the only scripture you had, if he was on a desert island for 40 years and the only scripture you had is Jesus wept, do you know you can never exhaust that scripture? Because it's alive. God has no beginning, he has no end. Yeah. You listen, after 40 years, you'd come back, you'd have so much revelation on Jesus wept. My God, you'd write encyclopedias on Jesus wept. Because he's alive. It's alive. It's living. He has no beginning. He has no end. Our daddy. Who's your daddy? The Father of glory. Oh, don't miss it. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. You know that when I was telling you about that church in New England, because that you thought I forgot, but I didn't. That church in New England, that on the second week there's a newspaper reporter came, because she came by and saw the cars at late at night. She came and came in. We actually just sat there and took the writing about the meeting. Then afterwards, she said she's a reporter. Can I take pictures? And so she took pictures, and they had this one picture of me and this person on the floor. And she said, "Can we do an article?" I said, "Yeah." I thought typical, article of the newspaper, secular newspaper that goes throughout all New England is going to be in the back somewhere in a corner. I wake up the next. That was Friday night. I wake up. That was Sunday. I wake up Monday morning. Somebody slid a newspaper underneath my door. Front page. $40,000 worth of advertisement free. Front page, big bold letters across the front of the Concord monitor. The words, capital letters, drunk in the spirit. It had a picture of me praying with somebody and somebody on the floor. Do you know when that hit? It hit all over New England. Do you know that people from all 6 states in New England came to the meeting? We had to move buildings. It was probably almost the size of this building, maybe 3/4 the size. We had to move buildings to a bigger building, because everybody starts coming. We could have stayed there for months, because everybody starts coming. Matter of fact, the building we moved into, they quickly, freshly painted the walls. And that night, the walls wasn't finished drying, but the power of God hit people, and the people would be thrown up against the wall like this, and they'd come and start running, the whole box paint on the back of the wall. Oh, yeah. Glory to the Lord. I'm going back there next year since 20-some years. Oh, ra-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma. Oh, I'm talking about the glory. Oh, I'm talking about the glory of God. Oh, come on over. Come up higher. Come understand who you are. Understand we are the church, the blood-bought church. We are the church of the redeemed. Shaka hata hata. Oh, yeah. Hombre, I remember. Oh, the glory of God. I'm talking about the times of the glory. I can tell you about things that's just happened this next few days, last few days. The pastor's mom last week, the pastor's mom in the church, we was up in him at the pastor's mom. God healed the pastor's mom last week. Oh, my, the glory. Yeah. But yet, isn't it amazing? You hear these people, oh, if you just knew what I knew, if you could just taste what I tasted, you wouldn't be going after all that other demonic stuff. Because, understand, if the Spirit of God's not in it, understand where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. But where the Spirit of the Lord is not, there's bondage. Amen. Everything you accept into your life that's not of God, that's not of the Holy Ghost, produces bondage.
It's true.
Which in turn will get you into living a life of sin again.
It's true.
And God will be on your lips. It's your heart will be far from Him.
Right.
And you'll be found like the church of Ephesus. I have something against you. I don't know about you, but I don't want the Lord to have anything against me.
Yeah.
And I remember this pastor called me. We want you to come to our church. It's probably about 500 people in Texas. We want you to come and have a revival here. I said, you know, Pastor, when we come, let me tell you what's going to happen. Just be ready. Very first Sunday morning, the fire of God fell. People took off running. Like I'm about ready to. People took off running. Listen, if I take off, you better take off too. Some of you never ran in the Holy Ghost, it's time. Some of you never danced in the Holy Ghost, it's time. Do you know, here's the thing you have to understand about meetings like this. Your victory, your freedom lies in your yielding. As you yield, you'll be filled. As you yield, you'll be healed. It's all in yielding. And it might come because the Spirit of the Lord speaks to you. You say, run. I've never ran a church. Run. See, if you disobey, then the very thing you came crying out for, You won't leave with, because you didn't yield.
Right.
You got to yield. See, God doesn't do it our way. God doesn't do it our way.
Right.
Do you know God will never, never, nor has He ever, God has never sent a revival to conform to the way man thinks a revival should be.
Never.
God sends it His way. God Himself comes and He expects us to hook up with Him.
Yes.
Right. Amen.
Yes.
And as you yield, you'll be healed. As you yield, you'll be filled. And it might be the Lord speak to you, run. You know what? You just got to forget about what people think. Because most people don't think anyway. Just do it. Because, just yield. No, just yield. Because the moment you just take that step, you will step right into the very thing you've been crying out for. You step right into the glory. You step right into the miracle. Because it's in yielding.
Yes.
Shakalabashita. You got to yield. That's what the Holy Ghost is saying. As you yield, you'll be filled. As you yield tonight, you'll be healed. As you yield, you'll be filled. As you yield, you'll be healed. As you yield, you'll be filled. As you yield, you'll be healed. As you yield, the fire Rabada. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I feel it. I feel it. Ah, ha, ha, ha. I feel it. Glory. It's the 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 glory. The Father of Glory's here tonight. Now, I just gotta tell you, as I went to that church, the fire on Sunday morning, the fire of God hit. Sunday morning. Usually it takes us a couple of weeks to get to that place. But the fire of God fell. Sunday morning, people take off running. There's still like 500 people there. I'm not talking about one or two. The fire of God, people took off. Actually, everybody, I had to actually tell the people, look, if you're going to run, run the same direction. Sunday night, the fire of God fell. Sunday morning. We just had Sunday morning. Monday morning. Whew. Monday morning. Had a morning meeting. The pastor then comes to me, calls me. He says, Brother Richard, we're going to have to end these meetings on Wednesday. I said, Pastor, we're supposed to go through Friday. He said, I know, but we need to end on Wednesday. Listen, I told him, I said, look, Pastor, it's not my first rodeo. This is what I do. This is what I do. This is what the Lord spoke to me when the Lord spoke to me in April of 92. The Lord spoke to me and he said, take the move of my spirit to the church. Take the move of my spirit to the churches. That's what he said to me. That's my call. I guess it's like I'm a church revivalist. I mean, that's my call. And I haven't asked, it's been all these years, I haven't asked the Lord to do anything else. People come to me all the time, well, I think you should be a pastor. Stop. Stop. You get out of your carnal mind. Get out of your head. No, listen. And I haven't been seeking, Lord, you want me a pastor? You know what? Because he's my father. And I'm obeying him. When the Lord's ready for me to do something else, just like he spoke to me in April of 1992, up in my spare bedroom where there was a desk sitting there in upstate New York, he can speak to me about something else. If he wants me to be a pastor, he'll tell me. And until then, if he ever does, I'm going to keep doing what he told me to do. Amen. Here it's been now, it's been all these years, and I'm still doing what the Lord told me to do. I'm still doing what the Lord told me to do. Amen. I'm not looking to do anything else. Amen. I'm not looking to do anything else. When he's ready for me to do something else, he'll tell me. But until then, I'm going to keep doing what he told me to do in 1992. Amen. You'll get in trouble when you start. Listen, that's why people get in trouble. Because the Lord tells them to do something, they'll do it for a season, then they get a little discouraged or tired or whatever, and they start seeking something else. Right. Next thing, they're supposed to be walking this way. Next thing, no, they're going this way. They're going this way. They're supposed to be over there, and they're over here, and they wonder why they're in the desert, and why it's desolate, and why there's no miracles, and why there's no signs and wonders, and why it's so hard. Because you're not supposed to be here. You're supposed to be there. Because you got away from what he told you to do.
Right.
Because understand something. Your provision is in what he told you to do.
Right.
Hello.
Yes.
Don't come to me and tell me I need a pastor. Stop. I'm doing what the Lord told me to do. I do what he tells me to do, not what you tell me to do.
Amen.
And you should be that way. And you know what? And every time the Lord confirms it. And you know what? And if the Lord spoke to me, come do something now. I'm so close with this guy. He would confirm it. That's why you gotta have people in your life that know God.
That's right.
Yes. Not the people off from seeking some sensation seekers. Woo, the latest. Woo. And that's what they do. That's why their life's a wreck. That's why they're in a spiritual jump heap.
Because their life's a wreck and their life's a mess because they've hewn them out cisterns that can hold no water anymore. Because they've changed the glory of God. They've gotten away from the glory of God for that which profiteth not.
It's true.
Hello. And I said to the pastor, listen, that's just what I do. What is he or she saying? Because I knew some religious person got to him. And it's always just one or two. And you know the thing that I can never ever understand about pastors? When there's a move of God going on, there's 500 people there. Why are you going to shut something down over one person? And they're always the people with money. But when you're dead to money, you're not moved by money. You need to get that. When you're dead to money, you're not moved by money. But when you're alive unto God, you're only moved by God.
Yes.
Yeah. I can tell you right now, I can promise you, material things have absolutely no hold on me. None whatsoever. Because the point it does start to get a hold on me, the Lord tells me to give it away. Just here in May, I'm sitting in the meeting. My wife's not even with me. She's at home. And I'm sitting in a camp meeting, and the Lord speaks to me and says, give your alabaster box. I knew immediately what it was. My alabaster box is my golf clubs. Because they are all customs, everything. Custom driver, custom shape, everything's custom. Custom, the bag, I had a nice big bag. I had took my driver. The driver's like a $500 driver. I had a special, painting, decal put on it with University of Kentucky basketball. And the Lord spoke to me and said, sow it. I knew immediately. And I knew I was to sow it to him. I knew immediately. But you know what? You know why I jumped up and down and rejoiced? I didn't even have to think about it. I didn't say, Lord, are you sure? Nothing. I just with, it wasn't even a second. Okay, Lord, you don't know how much that blessed me to know that material thing has no hold on me. That just like that, I can just obey the Lord and just release it and give it because it has no hold on me.
Amen.
Do you know if the Lord speaks to you, tells you to give something, you can't give it, it owns you.
Yeah. It's true.
And I think partly I'm that way because I watched my friend. I watched my dear friend. I watched my friend who's also my pastor. I watched him hold his 18-year-old daughter in his arms as she was taking out her last breath. That did something to me. When you watch your friend hold his 18-year-old daughter and he dies, she dies in his arms. Actually, he was holding her and I actually left because he needs to be alone. I was in the hospital, it was like 3 a.m, I was there. Material things just don't have nothing, And besides that, when you get in the presence of God, everything that's in there, listen, understand, God wants every of your life to be submissive to Him because He's Lord. He's Lord. He's Lord of our life. He's Lord of the friends you keep. He's Lord of the things you watch. Come on. And I find the more you're in His presence, the more the fire of God just begins to burn everything of this world out. Everything that's of this world out. I remember one time that Smith Wigglesworth said the man was standing in Smith Wigglesworth's house. Smith Wigglesworth was up in his bedroom sleeping. And so the man was going upstairs. Smith Wigglesworth came off of his bed and they met in the stairs. And he said Smith Wigglesworth was crying. And Smith Wigglesworth said, he said, George, the Lord just spoke to me on your bed. And George, he said, I could see it in his eyes. His eyes were sparkling. He said, I could see it, just like I could see it in his eyes. And Wigglesworth said these words to him. He said, the Lord just spoke to me on my bed. And the Lord said to me, Smith, I'm going to burn you all up to where there's no more Smith Wigglesworth. And it's just all me.
Beautiful.
And that's really what's happening tonight, burning you all up.
Yeah.
There's no more you.
Yes.
It's just all him.
Yes.
And when it's all him, the things of this world means nothing. The things of this world means nothing. The things of this world means nothing. The things of this world means nothing.
The things of the world mean nothing. And I said to the pastor, what's he saying or she's saying? Here's what he said to me. He said, son, he said, you've lit more fires in two services than I've seen the whole lifetime of my ministry. I said, you want a revival because I carry the fire. I carry that glory. Where I go, he goes. And I said to him, pastor, you can set the meetings down if you want. I said, but you better make sure that you're doing it because the Lord's telling you to do it. I know he wasn't, but you better make sure the Lord's telling you to do it. Because I said, if you yield to that spirit of, here's what I said to him, if you yield to that spirit of religion, you'll be bound to that spirit. You'll be bound to that spirit of religion. I said, first off, and if you grieve the Holy Ghost, he'll leave. You might not get him back. Don't grieve him. I said, because the very thing you've been crying out for is here. It just didn't come in the package that you thought it was going to come. And I said, if you grieve him, you might not get him back. And I said, you better make sure that you're doing it because you feel in your spirit that the Lord's telling you to do it, not because you're yielding to religion. Because the moment you yield to religion, it'll control you and it'll dictate your life. And here's what I said to him. I said, your whole life will be yielded to that spirit of religion. You'll have to ask that woman when you've got to go pee, if you can go pee. That's what I said to him. Because you'll be bound by the spirit of religion. That's what I said. That's exactly where I tell you, I said it. Then you know, I said, let's go have lunch. I got to talking to him. And he's like, have you ever seen that commercial? There used to be a cologne called the High Karate. You know the High Karate come in a green bottle? Remember there was a commercial where a guy would put it on and just slap himself. Anybody remember that? I'm dating myself. I'm telling you how old I am. Well, you remember it? Okay, see, I'm telling the truth. And we're sitting there talking. He smacks himself. He said, my God. He said, oh, what was I thinking? He said, and that's what religion does. It's like a fog come over me. And he said, my God, we ain't shutting these meetings down. Do you know, see, the enemy hated what's happening. Because let me tell you what happened that night. A lady, and I still remember her name. Her name was Tracy. That night, that Monday night, a lady came to the meeting. I seen the fire of God fall on her. Looks like I'm seeing it on everybody here. I saw the fire of God come on her. I had her stand up in the aisle. I said to her, I said, ma'am, just lift your hands and close your eyes. And she did. I said, as soon as you do that, the fire of God, it's like a wind. Whew, come and hit her. Do you know that woman had 52 tumors all over her body? I didn't know it. The woman had, the doctor had opened her up and saw that he operated on her three times. The doctor opened her up and saw the cancer. And the doctor said to her, here's what the doctor said. You've got six weeks to 2 months to live. The doctor said to her, go home, because he had two young kids, a young girl and a young boy. The doctor said, go home and create some memories for your kids to remember you by. That's what the doctor said. That night, the fire of God came on her. She gets stuck to the floor for a half hour. Can't move. Stuck to the floor for a half hour. Can't move. But you know what? During that half hour, she stuck to the floor. She said, my whole body's on fire. She said, the glory of God was on. She said, I couldn't move. But you know, one of the words for glory is the word heavy. It's like the heavy of God was on her. She couldn't move. The heavy was on her. But you know what? As she laid there on that floor with the heavy of God, the glory of God on her, her body burning like fire, all 52 tumors disappeared. That same meeting, there was a lady had an incurable blood disease. That same meeting had an incurable blood disease. Do you know I saw that? This meeting was the late 90s. I saw that woman 2 years ago in my meeting. She heard I was in town, comes back to my meeting, and guess what? I had her testify. It's been now almost 20 some years. Had her testify. She still healed of the blood disease. It's the glory. No, it's the glory. No, it's the glory. No, it's the glory. No, it's the glory. It's the glory of God. It's the glory of God. And you got to yield to it. Glory to God. Shoo. You got to yield to it. You got. That's why I see people in the meetings. They're sitting like this. Don't. Yield. Yield to it. Yield to it. Yield to it. Yield to it. Don't hold it back. Don't hold it back. Because remember, as you yield, you'll be healed. As you yield, you'll be filled. As you yield, you'll be set free. As you yield, you'll be delivered. As you yield, impartation will come. As you yield, you'll begin to see Him as He is. And yield to Him. Yield. As you yield, you'll begin to get revelation and understanding. And you'll begin to see your God. You'll begin to see your Father. You'll begin to see what family you are of. Yield. So I see people sometimes, I see them in the meeting, stand, yield to that, don't hold that back, yield, let that joy flow out of your belly, because out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. You got to yield to it. Do you know tongues comes from the same place joy comes from? Just if you can yield to tongues, you can yield to that joy. It comes from the same place. I see people sitting. I watch people sometimes. I watch them in the meetings. They're sitting in the chair. They're sitting like this. Stop! Yield! Don't dance in your seat. Yield to it. Just jump up and take off dancing. Yield to it. Because your miracle's in your yielding. No, you got to get that. Your miracle's in your yielding. Your healing's in your yielding. Your victory's in your yielding. The answer you need from God for that situation that looks impossible is in your yielding. Yeah. Come on. Yield. Go. 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 Yeah!
Some of you still are sitting in your seat. You want to so bad. You want to yield, but something's holding you back. Get the victory now. Get the victory over there. Take off. Yield. 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 Comes. The breakthroughs come. Yeah, that's it, sister. That's it, sister. That's it, you. Coming off. Her belt. Forgot to put a belt on. Do you know? I was in a church in Louisiana. Woo! Glory to God. And just like a minute ago when I threw the water just now, I was in a church and I threw the water. That's the first time I did it in years. And the fire was like liquid fire hitting people. Then I went and got another bottle of water, threw it. Got another bottle of water. Then somebody, I ran out of water. And then somebody goes and gets me a pitcher. Pitcher. So I went to just to throw it. And when I threw it wrong, and it all hit one man. But here's what happened. The Lord orchestrated it that way
Because when I threw the water, the reason why he was standing up, because he was on like 20 some different medicines. He had was in a major car accident. Could never do anything with his back. In tremendous pain. He just stood up to relieve the pain. And when the water hit him, he said, and the doctors, he was just a worst bad case. He said when the water hit him, he said it felt like liquid fire hit him and shot up and down him. And his back began to pop, 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 pop. And he was totally healed by the power of God. Woo! As you yield, you're filled. As you yield, you're healed. Huh. You know what? That sounds like a Holy Ghost song. That sounds like a song of the Spirit. As you yield, you'll be filled. As you yield, you'll be healed. As you yield, you'll step in the realms of God. You'll step in to the realms of glory. And you'll begin to see your Father. You'll begin to taste of His goodness. You'll begin to taste of His presence. You'll begin to taste of His mercy. You'll begin to taste of the Father, the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory. Woo! That's it, sister. Never the same. You'll never be. That's the power of God all over you. Never be the same. What's her name?
Deborah.
Huh? Deborah? That's never the same, Deborah. Never the same. That's never the same. That's the power of God. Never. Yeah. That's the fire of God. That's the fire of the Holy. Never the same. Can you imagine a whole week of this? We got to do a camp meeting, Pastor. While I pull my pants up. Oh! Woo! Sack out of. Come here, sweetie. Come here. How old are you? 10. That's the Holy Ghost, the fire of God all over. See, this is how we're supposed to raise up our kids. In the glory. In the glory. Whoo, she's shaking that body. Ah, the fire of God. The fire of God. You know, God's going to hold our generation and the generation before us. And you know, God's going to hold our generation accountable for not introducing the millennials to His glory, to His presence. This is how the kids are supposed to be raised. The kids are supposed to be raised up seeing the hand of God move. But they're supposed to, listen, it's our heritage. It's our heritage for the kids to go to sleep on the pews or in the chairs or under the chairs and waking up the next morning still in church because the Spirit of God's still moving. You know, my great-grandfather, he was 92 or 4 when he went home. And he was Pentecostal, the turn of the century when Pentecost first came. You know what he said to me? That's for the term where he was around when they come with the term Holy Rollers. He said when he was a boy, they used to throw eggs and tomatoes at him, call him Holy Rollers, the church. But you know what he said to me? He said, Sonny, and he said this to me when I was just young, I think I was still in Bible school or just got out of Bible school. He said to me, he said, I remember as a boy, this age, when revival broke out at the turn of the century, he like with Azusa Street and Pica Cans and different revivals. He said, I remember being in church as a boy. He said, I remember going to sleep in church, watching the power of God move, people shaking under the fire of God, waking up the next morning, 7, 8 o'clock in the morning, still in church. And the people still there, the Spirit of God still moving. See, that scripture I read to you so applies. Because as the generations go on, next thing you know, that which my great-grandfather was raised in is no more.
Right.
Because they hewn themselves out cisterns.
Right. Yeah.
Broken cisterns that can no longer hold any water. Religion got in. But not this generation.
No.
Not you. Not you. I'm telling you, San Diego will be shaken by the glory of God. San Diego will be shaken with the glory of God. San Diego will be shaken because the glory people, the glorious church of the Lord Jesus Christ arises and takes their place and begins to walk in their authority and begins to walk in their power and begins to walk in the signs and wonders and miracles, that when we walk down the streets of San Diego, our shadow overcomes the homeless man and he gets healed. Our shadow overcomes a blind man and he begins to shout because he can see. Come on. That's our heritage. That's our heritage. The book of Acts is how we're to live. The books of Acts is how we are to live. No, the book of Acts is the blueprint, how we live our life, how we conduct our life.
Amen.
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 Come on, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Some of you walk down the street going to Who Dads. Is that how I say it right? Who Dads or Ho Dads? Ho Dads. I went to Ho Dads the other day. There's a line of people. You just walk down the street and the power of God, boom, 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 starts hitting. Next thing you know, they're all on the sidewalk. It's how revival, it's what happens when the glory of God's tangible and present. Amen?
Yes.
Next thing you know, you stop on the street corner, you're reading the book of Isaiah. Come on.
Yes.
Next thing you know, you'll be getting people saved, taking them to the ocean, baptizing them in the water.
Amen.
Then boom, be translated.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Do you know, I used to work in the early 80s for a minister. His name was Rudy Vitoshnik. He's gone home to be with the Lord now. Very powerful. God used to use him when he went into Russia, when it was closed to the gospel and they had underground churches. He told me of a man that pastored three churches in Russia. And they were all hundreds of miles apart. But on every Sunday, he would speak at each church. Each Sunday, this happened for a long, I don't know how many long, I'm not going to say how long it happened because I don't know, because I want to be accurate. But it happened for a while. That every Sunday, he'd go into one church. When he'd get done preaching, the Lord would translate him to the other church. He'd preach and get done preaching, the Lord would translate him to another church. It's called the glory. Oh, Ramama. You got a song, Joshua? Just go and let the Lord give you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm sitting here running like this, Pastor. My pants were falling down. I'm running. My pants were falling. I had to hold my pants. We got home and Pastor was rushing me and I forgot my belt. No, he didn't rush me. I'm teasing. Ann did. And I'm teasing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we're not done yet. Holy Ghost song. Ramandi pray bosu pray. Prophesy on that guitar. Prophesy on those drums. Prophesy on that keyboard. Prophesy on that bass. Hallelujah. Shapra basifre basipra. Never the same. Lawrence, I just feel the Lord tell me to tell you that. Never the same. Never the same. Never the same. Because as you yielded, he began to supply. Oh, yeah. Never the same. Never the same. God just wants us to yield. Oh. Shakara basiste le bakita. Shaka. Don't go silent on me now. We're not done. We're going to just worship the Lord and get a Holy Ghost song. Hallelujah. You know what? You know how they used to do it in the old days? You know what? One guy would get up, flow with what God had him. He'd sit down, another preacher would get up. Then he'd flow with what God had to him. He'd sit down, another. No, that's how the meetings would go on for days. That's our heritage. That's our heritage. No, that's our heritage. That's our heritage. Even the Baptists are getting involved. Do you know just a couple months ago, the Baptist Convention, they just allowed tongues? Because they couldn't do anything with it, because all the Baptist missionaries around the world were getting filled with the Holy Ghost. They couldn't stop it. No, they couldn't stop it. And so now the Baptists, the late, just here a couple months ago, the Baptist Convention, they just now allow tongues in the Baptist Church. Ha ha! Yeah, better late than never.
Oh, how shall you feel? Well, how shall you I feel? Feels you're overflowing. Feels you're overflowing. Well, how shall you I feel? Well, how shall you? Feel to overflow.
what? Here's what I feel. Oh, mama. Glory to God. Woo!
Thank you.
Oh, mama, mama. Yeah. I love that. That's a Holy Ghost song. Healed. Healed, healed, healed. Healed, healed, healed. Ha ha. Field, field, field. Field, field, field. Oh! Healed, healed, healed. Oh! Healed, healed, healed. Oh! Healed,
healed, healed. I'm filled with the Lord. I'm filled with the Lord. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Yeah.
grab an offer and start waving it around. Grab an offer and start waving around. Oh, offering to the Lord. Come worship the Lord.
Yeah.
I'm so into the ministry. So into Richard and Rhonda's ministry. Hallelujah. What's God touch your finances? What's God touch the offering? What's God work a miracle? What's God work a miracle? As I yield, I am healed. As I yield, always yielded to Him.
Oh yeah.
Feel, I am filled. Feel, I am filled. Healed, I am healed. Heal, always yielded to Him.
Oh!
Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Lord, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. And as we worship, we yield to you. Always yielding to you, Lord. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The wonderful works of Jesus.
I need to pray for a few people. No, I just need to pray for a few people. I just need to pray for a few people. But you know what? The Lord told me somebody you yield. See, that's really the theme. As you yield, you be filled. As you yield, you be healed. As you yield, the breakthrough will take place. And the Lord just told me there's somebody here, the Lord spoke to you to give a certain amount and you yielded. The breakthrough's happened. No, the breakthrough happened. Now, I'm just going to, we'll pastors and them keep, listen, this, like we said, there's no end. And I'm just going to do what I feel like to do. Then every pastor do what he feels. But I just got to pray for a few people. Hallelujah. But I got to pray for Crystal Lawrence. I got to pray for you. And then Catherine's dad, let me pray for you. And is your wife with you? Was she? Come. Hallelujah. Come. I want to pray for this couple right here. I need to pray for this couple right here. Ha. 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 Oh, rabba, rabba. Come, Elizabeth. Ha. Oh, rabba, rabba, rabba. Oh, ramanete de basita. Oh, oh, rabba, rita, rabba, sita. I need to pray. I need to pray. Ha. Sister, right here. Right. In the white, yeah, come. And you come with her. And you come too, sister. You come, sister. Come, Geneva. Come, both your whole family. Come, sister, right in the block. Come in the block. Come here, you, and the sister behind you. Come, and sister with the baby. Come. Ha, 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 ha. Oh, yeah. I just had to obey the Lord. Ha. But the Lord told me to say that some of you obeyed the Lord and the breakthrough happened. Come here, sister. Come here, sister. Ha, ha. Come here, Robin, your wife. And Jacqueline. Come here. And the sister, beside Jacqueline. You come here. Hallelujah. Just come, just stand here. Ho, 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 Rabashita. Oh, and this couple right here. You bless me. You and your wife came dancing with your offering. That's how you're supposed to do it. Come stand here. Ha, 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 ha. Ha, 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 ha. Oh, my mama. Oh, my mama. Oh, my. Now the rest of it. Ha, 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 ha. Oh, yeah, rabasita. Some of you will find yourself on a foreign field preaching the gospel with signs and wonders and miracles. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, ramama. Oh, ramama. Because you know what this place is? This is a training ground. That's why Pastor can't get upset when people come and leave and go to the nations, because that's what this is for. That's what it's for. Amen? That's what it's for. You come here and you get equipped and you're thrust out. You're thrust into the nations, but not with just a message. A message is part of it. But you're thrust out with a message from heaven accompanied by a demonstration of the Holy Ghost. That's the glory church. That's the redeemed church. That's the New Testament church. If the New Testament church, any church that does not have signs and wonders in it, is not a New Testament church. We were talking about A.B. Simpson earlier, this in the car, on the ride home. You know what A.B. Simpson said? A.B. Simpson said this, for the church to not have signs and wonders in its midst is a disgrace to Almighty God and every true man. That was a statement by A.B. Simpson. Signs and wonders. 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 I hear that in my spirit so loudly. It's so loudly. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Now, I need you just to step up. Scoot up. Just come scoot up. I need to get ushers help me. How? How? Papa, yeah, mama, mama. How? Fire! Fire! Fire!
Fire!
How? Mama, mama. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Fire! 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 Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, ba, 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 ba. How, ba, 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 ba. How? Ha, 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 ha. Fire! Fire! To the nations. The nations. God use her. God use her. To shake her generation. To shake her generation. With the fire. The fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire. Fire. Shake your nation, brethren. Shake your brave papa. Fire! 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 Yeah! Yeah! Shake your generation! Shake your generation! Shake your generation! Never the same! Never the same! Shake all of us! Shut up! Oh yeah! Oh, ba 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 ba! Oh, ba 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 ba! Shake your generation. Total complete healing. Fire! 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 Oh! I gotta pray for Joshua and Allie. Oh yeah. Oh, break, 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 break. Ha ha. Oh yeah. It's bigger than you. Fire! It's bigger than you. Oh, my, 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 oh. Come right here. Come and come this spot right here. Oh, la, 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 just the beginning. Oh, the Lord's here to speaking. Not only will it come to pass, but speak bigger. Believe bigger. Because it's just the beginning.
Amen.
If it was to be told you the next 5 years, You a pinch yourself. Because you ain't going, it's way bigger than you.
Ah, fire! 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 Fire!
Fire!
Son. Fire! 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 Fire!
Fire!
Oh, la, 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 la. Oh, yeah. Woo. Oh, yeah. Shake your nation. Shake your generation. Jacqueline. Shake your generation. Signs and wonders, Jacqueline. Shake, shake, shake. Shake, 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 shake. Shake, 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 shake. Shake, 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 shake. Shake, 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 shake. Ali. Joshua. Shake, 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 shake. Shake, 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 shake. I heard the Lord say, it's bigger than what you're speaking. Oh, it's bigger. Not only will it be manifested, what you've been saying, but it's bigger than that. Far bigger than that. Oh, because there's just not one multi-million dollar business in you. There's multiple. Huh. There's multiple. In time, financier of the harvest. The fire of God. How? Songs of the Holy Ghost that will go around the world. Because there's a famine in the world when it comes to anointed music. He's speaking it. Just keep speaking it. Oh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Oh. Yeah. Fire! 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 Oh! Oh! Oh!
Signs and wonder.
Oh, la, 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 la.
Signs and wonder.
Oh!
Oh, God, to me. Signs and wonder.
Oh, yeah. Never the same. Never.
Dream.
Never.
God is moving.
Oh, fuck
that. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Signs and wonders. As you drink, fuck,
fuck, fuck, fuck, fuck.
Signs
and wonders. Oh, you know, I knew it because I was just getting ready to get her. She, oh.
Signs and wonders.
Fuck! Hell!
As a dream. Signs and wonders.
Oh, fuck, 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 fuck.
Signs and
wonders. Come down. Oh! Oh, bruh, Oh, yeah, my, 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 my. What about me, Lord? Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. These are the Holy Ghost. These are Sister Rondai, Shondai, Hondai. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Oh, signs. Signs and wonders. Jesus. Oh. Fire. Signs. Jesus and wonders. Signs and wonders. Fire. Signs. Fire and wonders. Fire. Fire. Signs and wonders. Oh, yeah. Come here. Come here. What's your name? Michael. How old are you, Michael? 12. What's happening? Huh? What's that?
The power of God.
The power of God. You got it, don't you? 12 years old. Signs and wonders. Fire, 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 fire. That's what it's about right there. 12 years old. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Oh, Ramane. Signs and wonders. Oh, fire. Fire, fire, fire. That's it. Signs and wonders. Oh, yeah, le, 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 le. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Signs and wonders.
God oh, is
good. Signs and wonders.
Signs and wonders. Let it move through you.
I can't forget about the sound team, the camera team. Come somewhere. We'll put you on the platform. Oh! Trying to get away, Lord. Signs and wonders. Help. Come, come to me. More platform. Signs and wonders. Ah. I tell you, this is the dancingest sound team I've ever seen. I've never, ever. Out of all the hundreds of churches I've been to, 31 years of full-time ministry, 7,000 revival service, I've never, ever been to a church where the sound team were back there dancing. Signs and wonders.
Saka piso.
Oh, bra bra freke.
Oh, saka papati. Panama soka.
Signs and oh yeah, fire! Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Signs, hombre, fire and wonders. Signs and wonders. Yeah, Jacqueline, shake your generation. Where's the ushers? I need to pray for the ushers. Come here, ushers. I need ushers for the ushers. Come on, ushers for the ushers. One more. Here we go. Lift your hands, ushers. Signs and wonders. Oh, rarere arob.
Jesus. Fire.
Oh, yeah. Fire, the Holy Ghost. Fire. Power of God going right in you. Jesus. Take it. Over your head and the soles of your feet. Fire. Signs and wonders. Come stand right there. Ha ha. No, I'm not going to forget that.
Signs and wonders.
Oh! You know people are hungry when it's 10 o'clock and they keep coming. But what does time mean anything? It don't mean nothing anyway. Signs and wonders. Fire. Oh, the fire of God. That's called hunger.
Signs and wonders.
Jesus. Fire. Isn't that right, Anna?
We're for signs and wonders.
Signs and wonders. Can you say signs and wonders?
Signs and wonders.
Say it loud. Sing it.
Signs and wonders.
Out of the mouths of babes. Signs and wonders.
I am the Lord and the children of the Lord. And I am the children of the Lord. The Lord has given to me for signs and wonders. For signs and wonders, I am the children of the Lord, which the Lord has given to me. For signs and wonders, for signs and wonders. For the signs and wonders.
Father, Pastor, will you come and lay hands on him? Sabra Bakita. Signs and wonders. Come on here, stand right here. Oh, come on, ushers. So Ramati.
Signs and wonders. You and me. The Lord says, I am the children of the Lord, which the Lord has given to me for signs and wonders. For signs and wonders. We the people that do miracles.
Yeah.
Children of glory.
Oh yeah. Children of glory.
The children of our Father.
Oh,
a heavenly people. Carry on the fire of the Holy Ghost for signs and wonders. We're for signs and wonders. We're the people of miracles. What Jesus said, I am the children which the Lord has given me. We bore the signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. The people of miracles. signs and wonders.
Oh yeah.
The heavenly people, with the carriers of the fire, the Holy Ghost, for signs and wonders. Signs and wonders, with people to do miracles. I'm the children that the Lord has given to me, with the signs and wonders. Signs and wonders. Miracles. Signs and wonders. With the carriers of his fire. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Signs and wonders.
Signs and wonders.
Signs and wonders, and we yield ourselves to you, Lord. We yield ourselves to you, always yielded, Lord. We yield ourselves to you, Lord. We yield ourselves to you. Always seeking. The Lord said, seek my face, seek my presence always. I said, always will I seek. Lord, always will I seek. Seek you alone, almost I. Always yielded to you. Lord, we yield to you. Lord, we yield ourselves to you for your glory. Lord, we yield ourselves to you. Reveal your glory. Lord, we yield ourselves to you. Have your way. You said, seek my presence always, so always we will seek your sign and wonders, your manifest presence, Lord. Reveal your glory. There's no limits to your love. There's a realm of heaven that will cure every sickness, heal every disease. There's a realm of glory and anointing that the whole world blindly seeks. Let the light now shine like the rising of the sun in the noonday glory. Let the light now shine. Let Jesus be revealed. Separated, consecrated, to living out this life. Separated, consecrated, to walking in this light. Separated, consecrated, that the Jesus life may be revealed like never before through me. These works and greater works for anyone who believes. Separated, consecrated, every minute of the day. Separated, consecrated, to walking in this way. The beauty of the Lord, be led by the Holy Ghost in power. The glory of His presence, it comes like the latter rain shower. Our blessed seems always in this way. Separated, consecrated, to walking with you, Lord. Separated, consecrated, to living out this life. Separated, consecrated, to the Jesus ministry. Separated, consecrated, to the Holy Ghost and fire. Separated, consecrated, to the early and latter rain. Separated, consecrated, to the rivers of God flowing. Separated, consecrated, living in the wellspring. I see the glory of the Lord abiding in His temple. I see the glory of the Lord abiding in His people. Glory of God, the glory of the Son, all the glory of the living God in me. I see the glory of the Lord arising among His people. I see the glory of the Lord. Miracles like never been seen before. I see the light of God like the heavenly worship. Oh, I see the light of God in the face of Jesus Christ the Lord. Separated, consecrated, to living out this life. This life from the Son of God revealed in me. signs and wonders and miracles like never seen before. The precious fruit of the earth that seeks every lost soul. Oh, consecrated, separated to this life of Jesus Christ. Consecrated, separated to walking in the glory of the Lord. I see the Lord. He's living in my life. I see His glory living out my life. Separated, consecrated to these greater works now seen. Separated, consecrated, Lord, we'll do anything. Holy Spirit, take my life, place me on the altar of your praise. Let your fire fall, let your fire burn in me. Let your fire fall, let your fire burn in me. Let your fire fall, let your fire burn in me. I built the altar, the wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready, send your fire now. The altar is built, the wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready. Send your fire now. The altar is built. The wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready. Send your fire. The altar is built, the wood is laid in order, the sacrifice is ready, send your fire now. The altar is built, the wood is laid in order, the sacrifice is ready, send your fire now. Holy Spirit, take my life, place me on the altar of praise. Let your fire fall, let your fire burn in me. The altar is built, the wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready. Send your fire now. The altar is built. The wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready. Send your fire now. Holy Spirit, take my life, Place me on the altar of praise. Let your fire fall. Let your fire burn in me. The altar is built. The wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready. Send your fire now. Let your fire fall. Let it burn in me. Let your fire fall. I will burn for thee. Holy Spirit, take my life. Place it on the altar of praise. Let your fire fall. Let it burn in me. A living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. Lord, let your fire fall. Let it burn in me. Your altar is filled. Your wood is laid in order. The sacrifice is ready. Let your fire fall. Send your fire now. Your altar is built. The wood is laid in order. Your sacrifice is ready. Send your fire now. Your altar is built. The wood is laid in order. Your sacrifice is ready. Send your fire. Holy Spirit, take my life. Place me on the altar of praise. Let your fire fall. Let it burn in me. Your altar is built, the wood is laid in order, the sacrifice is ready, send your fire now, send your fire now, send your fire now. Send your fire now, let it fall on me. Send your fire now, send your fire now. Lord, your fire now, it burns in me. A flaming fire, I'm a minister of the glory of the Lord and of his mighty power. Lord, your fire now. Oh, your fire now. Oh, Lord, your fire now. Burn.